Hey guys, there's a new Python library called PyGWalker, which lets you turn your Pandas data frame into a Tableau-style user interface for visual analysis. You can integrate it into your Jupyter Notebook or Streamlit app. Let me show you how to use it. First things first, you need to install it. Just one pip install PyGWalker in your command prompt or terminal and you're all set. Once that is done, you can import it together with Pandas. Next, for demo purposes, let's load the tips dataset, which looks like this. Here you can see the total bill amount, along with the tips, gender, whether the customer was a smoker or not, the day and time of the visit, and the size. Alright, now let's assume you want to explore this dataset. Instead of plotting it in different ways, you can simply call pig.walk and pass in your data frame. You could also specify if you want to use the dark or light mode. After executing this line, you will get this canvas with two tabs. Let me first switch to the data tab. Here you can inspect your data frame and check out some entries if you would like. You will notice that PyGWalker automatically labels the numeric values as measures and the rest as dimensions. Now let's switch back to the visualization tab. Like in Tableau, you can now drag and drop the available fields into the X and Y axis. So, for example, let me plot the total bill amount by day. To resize a graph, you can click here and choose the fixed layout mode. Now you can resize a chart. By default, PyGWalker picks a chart type for you. However, you can use other chart types like a line chart. But for our analysis, I will switch back to the bar chart. The cool thing is, you can drag additional fields into your chart to explore your data in a very intuitive way. So, for example, I will add the tips to the y-axis. And instead of the total sum, I might want to look at the average bill amount. If you want to remove a field, you can simply drag it back to the field list. Likewise, you can add multiple fields to the x-axis. Let's say I'm interested to see if smokers spend more money, and I want to see it for each day. Additionally, I also want the information if it was during dinner or lunchtime. To do that, you can use the color field. And I'm only interested in this result for male customers. So you can apply a filter by dragging the column into the filter field. Now I will select only male and confirm my selection. The values will be then filtered accordingly. And to remove it, you can either select all again, or simply drag it out of the filter field. I think it's a very interesting tool for quick exploratory data analysis. However, you can also export the charts. So, for example, I will export it to a scalable vector graphic, and this is what it looks like. Alright, now back in my Jupyter Notebook, you can add additional charts by clicking up here. And now you have a second canvas, where you can again explore your data. There are actually a couple of more options in PyGWalker, but I would encourage you to play around with it yourself. But one important feature is to export your code. So if you click the Export As button, you will have different options. First, let me export it as code. Next, I will hit the Copy to Clipboard button. Now, if I paste it into a new cell, you will see the specs of my dashboard. If I run pig.walk and specify my specs, you will get back the same dashboard. Alternatively, you could also export your settings as a file. If you do so, you will get a config.json file. Let me grab this config file from my downloads folder and paste it into my current directory. Now, if you want, you can also implement the PyGWalker dashboard into your Streamlit app. To demonstrate this, I have created the following app. After importing Streamlit, I will set some basic page configurations. Next, I will load our tips dataset and set up a title and subheader. The interesting part is here. We can now read the content from the config file and use pig.walk again in our Streamlit app together with the previous settings. All you need to do is specify Streamlit in the environment. This time I will also switch to the dark mode. Okay, and with that in place, let's spin up my app by running streamlit run app.py. Once my page is loaded, we will have the PyGWalker canvas in our Streamlit app. And, as before, you can now play around with your data directly in Streamlit. Okay guys, and that is all I have for you today. I will upload this Streamlit app and also the Jupyter Notebook to my GitHub repo. You will find the link in the description box of this video. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.